Welcome to the Lumbridge Night quest guide for Ernest the Chicken. All you really need for this quest is the ability to withstand a level 22 skeleton for about 2 seconds. Honestly, even a level 3 could do this quest. All the items can be found on the quest. This is 4 easy quest points and 300 GP. Get it done. Welcome to the Lumbridge Night. Remember to subscribe and like our videos if you don't want to miss out on any of the hints, tips, tricks and guides that we're going to be bringing you on this channel. So without further ado, let the questing begin. Okay, so as you can just see, we're in Draynor Manor. This is a really early part of the game. It's only a short walk from Lumbridge. And we're going to speak to Veronica. She is the quest giver. So we're just going to run through the narrative here. Just quick a few clicks on the screen. Nothing too complicated. Basically, Ernest went looking for something inside the creepy mansion and hasn't come out. And now she's worried about him. So we're going to go in. Now, when you're making your way forward, if you're really low level like me, watch out, don't go wandering in this wood, because there's a few of the trees, as you can see there, it didn't do any damage, but when you've only got 10 hit points, they only have to hit you a few times, because they can do 1 to 2 damage at low level. There's a few green plants as well, which attack you. And also, once you go through the front door, you are trapped inside. The only way to come out of the manor is to go all the way through it. So head straight up the stairs. Ignore the creepy chair. The quest is actually up that spiral staircase, but before we go up there, we're going to grab the fish food there. You can see that kind of like blue box. You're all right from the ghosts. I kind of ran just to be sure, but the ghosts didn't seem to be aggressive, but I still wouldn't hang around. So yeah, moving on. Now we can go actually progress the quest and find out where on earth Ernest is. Also, you'll notice how I cut out there, because I went around to where through the room, and you don't really need to. Head straight up the stairs and speak to the mad professor, Professor Oddenstein. I'm looking for a guy called Ernest, and lo and behold, Ernest's here. He's the chicken that's walking around on the floor, hence the name of the quest, Ernest the Chicken. Click through the narrative and the professor will tell you he needs a rubber hose, a pressure gauge and an oil can in order to repair the machine and transform Ernest back into a human. Why you pick the fish food up will become clear later on in the quest, but for now you just needed that. Head back down and head straight back down to the ground floor. You'll notice that I'll be walking because I don't have any energy potions and I'm trying to save my run for the skeleton and for when I'm outside so the trees don't whack me to death. Turn to your left as soon as you come down and head into this room here where the skeleton's lying on the floor and pick up the poison. This is like a storeroom of some descript. Don't worry, that skeleton is dead. And now we need to head to the back door, so we're heading the opposite direction. We're going along here. If you can see there, that's the skeleton who's level 22 and that's the rubber hose we need, but we can't get in there because we need a key at the moment. So head through this door. There's a bronze medium helmet, a bucket, and a spade. You don't need the bucket, but you definitely need the spade. You can see that I've cut in and out there, because the first time I did this, I didn't pick the spade up for some stupid reason. So make sure you pick the spade up if you want to, if you need the money. I'm playing on an Ironman account, so I need every penny I can get. So I'll grab the bronze medium helmet, and I'll head out the back. The reason it's important you grab the spade is because, like the front door, the back door locks behind you. I know there's a couple of quests to take place in Draynor Manor, so look out for those quest guides in the future. Vampire Slayer is definitely one that I'm working on, so that'll be released shortly if it isn't already there in the playlist. So now when you get round to the compost heap, go search it, and because you've got the spade, you can search through it, and you find yourself a brass key. Yeah, you'll see how this cuts, so you needed the spade the first time, you only want to do one run. So now we head over to the water fountain or the pond, and if you try to put your hand in there, you'll get bitten. So what you want to do is combine the poison and the fish food, use that on the fountain. The piranhas are dead and there's a pressure gauge at the bottom that you can pick up and add to your inventory. So now we have the key, the pressure gauge, and we're heading back inside, so we have to do a full lap and go back in the front door. Remember, the front door seals behind you, so we've got to do it in fluid runs, hence why I skipped out the bit where I missed the spade. Don't miss the spade. Okay, so we're going to head in now, and we're going to get the rubber hose from the skeleton under the stairs. Now, as soon as you walk through that door, he will start attacking you. So go in, right-click on the rubber hose ready, click to collect it, turn around and get the hell out of there. He won't follow you out the door, so you're okay, it seals behind. Now, as you can see there, I walked it and took like one damage, and I am a fifth level character. Like, I'm not a high level at all. So even a level 3 straight off Tutorial Island will not get killed by that skeleton. Now, head into the study, search the bookcase for a secret passageway, and head downstairs. As soon as you get to the bottom of the ladder, look around for two levers in the large room, and pull levers A and B down, as is just scrolled up on the screen. The first two levers in the big room, put them down. You'll see if you hover over them, it'll say what letter they are. Now, once you've got the two levers in the down position, you can see that one of the doors popped open. So click on that to head straight through there to the room with the two tables and chairs. And once through there, you only need to touch one lever. So only put lever D down this time and leave C where it is. Now head through that open door and head back out into the main big area. I went through an extra door here for some reason. You don't need to go through there. Head straight back out into the main area where you came from and put levers A and B in the up position. This is all, by the way, to get the oil can. The oil can, there you can just see at the top of the screen, is in the last room. Now we need to open all the levers in the right sequence in order to open that final door. If anyone's interested, if this is a bit too complicated, I'm going to put in the description the link to the fandom wiki page for the quest, so you can see a written tutorial of how to do it. So that'll be in the description underneath the video. We're going to head through levers E and F now. So head through the now open doors. You can see the crypt for the vampire up in the distance there. And put levers E and F in the down position. Head back through to the area with the two tables. Remember, we left lever C. Now pull lever C down. Like that. Head back through where we just came from. Pull lever E up. And now you can see there's a path opened back into the main area. And also the door to get the oil can is now open. So let's head through there, grab the oil can, and I make that all three items. So now we can go turn Ernest back into a human. So hopefully if you've got some run, use it, unlike my character who's having to walk the whole way. I've got a little bit of energy, but I could really do with being a member and getting some energy potions and or some much higher agility. You can see from the quest there, I've got all three of the items. Pull this lever to open up the secret passage. That's not so secret because you can see it obviously. And head back up the large center stairs and then back up the spiral stairs to Dr. Oddenstein, was it? I don't know what the significance of the weird dancing chair is, but don't worry, the chairs don't hurt you. Stay away from the ghosts. As I say, I don't think they're aggressive, but best to avoid because they're much higher level. Yeah, Oddenstein. Give him all the stuff. He fires some magic ray from his machine. Boom. Hey, presto. Ernest is human again. And that's the end of the quest, so there's your 4 quest points and 300 gold coins. All in the space of about 8 minutes. So you can see it's not a very difficult quest, you can do it at any level. If you're really worried about the skeleton, just make sure you bring a little bit of food with you. Everything for the quest is in Draynor Manor, so you don't really need to bring anything with you, unless you're worried about the skeleton, in which case bring a couple of shrimp is probably all you need to recover. Just remember the one-way circuit. So as you can see now, I've got to kind of go out the back door to get out. And you can farm bronze medium helmets if you so desire. They're not worth a huge amount of gold, but as I say early on, you may as well take them. So I've managed to take 3 during the course of this. But yeah, now you don't have to go all around the back. You can pop around the front, as you can see from here. And, you know, that'll draw the video almost to a close. There's just time for me to say, if you found this guide at all useful, please like and subscribe to my channel. And look out for any future quest guides in the free-to-play members area. Also, if you have any suggestions, please get in touch. I'm happy to bring whatever content you desire. And look out for the Ironman series and a speedrun quest series that I'm currently working on. And this is the Lumbridge Knight, signing off. Peace out, guys.